Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Power Platform TV. Today, we're going to take a look at embedding a Power Automate flow inside of Power BI. Okay, so I wrote a blog post about this, and I actually wrote a blog post about a similar scenario of embedding Canvas apps inside of Power BI. And this time, we're going to do Power Automate. So this is kind of like a new feature that's come out with release wave one of 2024. And this was released, the release plans basically came out about a week or so ago. And I have actually the plan up here on my screen. And you can see here, this is what we're going to be talking about. So view a Power Automate visual inside a Power BI report. Okay. So we can see here that it says April 2024, we get general availability. And we have the preview functionality available right now. And so what we can do is basically take a look at an example of how to use this, and then when general availability comes along, you'll be able to hit the ground running. Okay, so let's take a look at what it says here in this document. It says, this feature helps you translate insights into action. With a Power Automate visual, you can run an automated flow from a Power BI report. Furthermore, the executed flow can be data contextual. So you're basically passing in data from the Power BI report into the Power Automate flow. So you get the context there. And that basically makes it useful, right? If you didn't have that context, then sure, you could do some stuff, but it's not going to be as interesting, right? So we'll see how to pass that context along. And it says here the feature details. When you create a Power Automate visual in a Power BI report, your users can run an automated flow just by pressing a button on the report. So we'll see when we drag that visual across, we'll get the button, and then we'll show you how to basically connect the button to the report data. And then we'll build a basic flow that runs, and then you can see the see the end-to-end flow as it's happening, okay? So we're gonna build this all out, and like I said, I wrote a blog post about it. This is the post here. We're gonna go through very similar steps in here. And I have a Dataverse environment over here. And this here is, you know, so a very simple example. What we'll do is we'll create the Power BI report. We'll put a couple of fields on there. We'll put the account field and the contact field, okay? So just the two columns basically on the report. We'll see a list of accounts, and then when a user clicks on one of the fields in the accounts, it will filter out the contacts who are associated with those accounts, right? And then what we can do is we'll take the we'll put a button on the form that we'll call the Power Automate flow, and it, you know, whatever record they have selected on the Power BI visual, that will be passed through into the flow, and then we'll basically be able to use that data. Okay, so here I have a couple of contacts, and they are tied to a couple of companies here. So we've got Bob Smith, he's part of Trait Research, and Claudia Mazzanti here is an employee or a contact for Fourth Coffee, okay? So let's go ahead and build out our Power BI report now. So let me open up Power BI, and here is a new Power BI report. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get data from another source here, and I'm basically signed in here as well to my org. And I'm gonna go down to the Power Platform here, and I'll use the Dataverse connector, okay? So I'm gonna click connect here, and this will connect to the Dataverse. So I have a couple of orgs here within this one, and I'm just gonna use this trial org. And I'll just expand this here, and we'll grab a couple of tables. So I'm going to grab the account here, and then if we scroll, let me do search here actually for contact. And I'm going to grab contact. And I'm going to click load. Okay. So we should see two of these fields now, two of these columns from the two different tables. I'm going to use import here, so it'll just import it directly into the data set. And let's create a couple of tables here. So I'm going to drag over the account name as the first column in our table here. And we got four records here of the accounts. So now the next thing I'm going to do is I will go to the contact here, and I'm going to, let's search for full name. and I'm going to create another table here, and this has the contacts. Okay, so now that we have this relationship between the two, if I click on Coffee Lab, for example, here, we have no, let me just kind of resize this so it's a little bit nicer to look at. Coffee Lab has no contacts. Fourth Coffee has a contact here. Graphic Design Institute does not have a contact, and Tree Research does have a contact. Okay, so that's kind of what we're looking at. That's perfect. So now what I'm going to do is, we see here under visualizations, right? This is where we have the Power Automate for Power BI. Okay, I'm going to click on this. So this is the new one here. And let's just go and expand this here and we can read it. So it says, create a button that triggers automated tasks without leaving Power BI. Okay, so here's the steps. We add the data, set up the flow, apply and share, and then we can format our button here that's created, okay? So the first thing is to add the data, and we're gonna take the account name, okay? So if we go back over to the account here, account name, and so with this selected here, I'm gonna select the account name, and now let's go ahead and click edit. And that's going to take us into Power Automate here. And we can see that it's kind of, you know, just displaying Power Automate within the, still within Power BI, right? So it's not actually opening a page somewhere else, but it's actually displaying it inside here. And we have the flows here that we can select. What I'm going to do is create a new one here. So create a new instant cloud flow, okay? So we'll do this from scratch. Great, okay, so now we are in Power Automate. I'm going to click new step here. And here I'm going to add an email step. So if we just go in here and we select send an email, and I'm going to send this to myself. So that's pretty straightforward. And then the subject here, let's just put Power BI test. And you can see already these insert parameters have come up, right? So I can insert parameters from Power BI that are getting passed across in the context. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put these into the body here. So let's just select a bunch of these, right? And you can see here we have the Power BI data account name. I'm just going to ignore that one. And the same thing with the data item. I'm just going to print out these other ones here. Because otherwise, what will happen is we'll go into a loop. And you know, we'll have to process the loop. But what I just want to do is send one email to myself here with some of this information. Okay. So let's go and do this. This all looks good. I'm going to go ahead and click Save here. And then we got the save and apply, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And let's take a look at how this works, right? So if I go back over here to the report, and you know, here's the button, and it's kind of like a big, giant, ugly button, right? So what we'll do is we can kind of resize this and make it look a little nicer here. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that. You can change the colors, and you can change the text here as well. Let's go ahead and change the text actually. So it says run flow, and let's go over here and what we'll do, change the button text, and we're just gonna say like send email, okay. So that looks a little nicer there. So we're basically ready to run this now. And what we'll do is, so you can see I have the account name selected already. And if I go ahead and what I'm gonna do is click control on my keyboard, and then I'm going to click the mouse button on the send email here. And you can see it says triggering, right? So if you, you know, and now it's triggered. So the flow should have run. If I did not click that, so if I was just clicking with my mouse to try to click send email here, nothing's going to happen. And I don't love this UI, to be honest. As an end user, you're kind of like, you know, you see a button and you want to click it, right? You don't expect to click control in order to get to the click, right? So that's something kind of to be wary of, and hopefully the product group will fix that, you know, but let's see how that goes. So let's take a look now and see at the, on the email. So what I'm gonna do is go to my email here, and let's see if an email's come through. And here it is. So it says Power BI test, so that's awesome. And we can see some of the values here, right? So here we have like a GUID, and these are the fields that we pasted into that body, right? We have my name here, my email address, some date stuff, and then some Power BI values. So because I had Tree Research selected over here, it has passed that account name across, right? So that's the field and that's the value that I am sending across here. And then it does come across in some of the other fields as well. Okay, so there's different things you can do with this. Let me go back over here and then, like, let's take another example here. So if I were to uncheck this, right? So now I have basically all the accounts in here. If I were to go and click send email now, let's wait for that to run. Okay, so it's run and we have four accounts here. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what it looks like now. So we have the new email that's come in and you can see we're getting like all of the accounts here. Okay, so that's something there. And then let's go hop back over and, you know, let's say we wanted to get the name in here as well, right? So I have account name set up here. And if I go to, let's say full name and I selected it here. So now that's tied into the button here as well. And if I were to go and hit trigger here now, let's go back, hop back over. And here's our new email. And you can see that I'm getting the contacts here as well now, right? So I'm getting both of those fields coming through. So let's go and hop back over one more time. We're going to take a look again at the flow. So I'm going to hop back here and then I'm going to go to edit the flow. And then just wait for that to load. So we're going to select the flow here that we created. And I think it's actually this first one here. I could go for a better name probably. We can rename it up here. And so here it is here, and then Power BI test, yeah, this is the one. So now let's try something. So let's say, you know, I put in the account data name here, and then now, so we have the apply to each, right? So what I'll do here as a parameter, I'm gonna put in, let's put in the Power BI data full name here, okay? So now theoretically it should do this for each of the instances. So if I click save and apply, and then I'm gonna go back to the report. And all this stuff is pretty instant, right? You know, you can see the changes that are being made instantly. It's not like you have to publish anything or anything like that, which is kind of interesting. So now we're ready to go. So I'm going to select tree research here. And so I've selected only one account. Okay, so I'm not selecting all the accounts. I have one account selected. I'm gonna click send email. And we should probably get one email here, I'm thinking. So let's hop back over. And here's our one email. And there is the contact associated with the account, Bob Smith. Okay. So now let's go back and select two. So if I go and select, so fourth coffee had Claudia here. So I'm going to select two of these now. We have two contacts. And now if I go ahead and click send email. Now let's hop back over to Outlook. And you can see here, now we got the two emails, right? So it's in the for each loop, it's going through each one of these records and it's sending the specific values, right? So, you know, just in case you missed it, this is in the title here for one of them, and then this is here for the other one, right? So that's how the looping works. That's kind of it. You know, it's a kind of an interesting feature, I think. I think it could use a little bit more usability, but it's got some potential, right? And, you know, I it's kind of all these Power Platform family features coming together in their different parts of the family, right? So you get some opportunities to use, you know, this different functionality. And I'm going to do a video on the Canvas apps one as well, embedding a Canvas app inside of Power BI. That's something that I wrote a blog post about as well. So we'll go through that example and you'll see how that works. That's it. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you.
So that's it, guys. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and of course, check out my blog at carldesouza.com. Thank you.